I am the Crowncorder, model CTR 9650S, all transistor, compact cassette tape recorder. And I have a secret. Historical documentation of a tape recorder that was made in 1968 by the Crowncorder or Crown Radio Corporation of Japan. At the time, all the wave on TV and movies was around spy programs such as I Spy, James Bond, Maxwell Smart, Man from U.N.C.L.E. and other programs. And they wanted to capitalize on this popularity, so they designed a machine that was basically a surveillance tape recorder. Now here's where history gets very interesting. Also in 1968, Congress passed a law forbidding the surveillance tape recording of a third party without their consent. Now, and the battery compartment has a date time code on this machine, which is 1968. But also on the battery compartment, which is located here, we have a date from the previous owner, which is 2/10/70. Now, the owner went through the machine and disabled the secret recording capability. So this machine is not a spy recorder, it is simply a tape recorder. It is unusual in the fact that there is a cassette recorder located here, but there is also a second recorder, which is activated by this button here. Now that is not a secret tape recorder, it is a 15-second loop tape recorder, and we'll see that later in the video. Obviously, you have your tape up, eject, record, rewind, play, fast forward, and stop. Here we have an ALC circuit. Here is the button for the repeating mechanism, which is the second tape recorder. You have a meter for battery and for level, and it will operate both on AC and batteries. It's a 6-volt system. This is AC bias. It has a 3-digit tape counter, a tone control, a volume control, and a storage compartment for 2 extra cassettes. The microphone and all the inputs and outputs are located in this compartment here. And here is remote, mic, auxiliary, and earphone. To make a recording on the Crowncorder for the cassette, it's very simple. You simply put the cassette into the machine, plug in your microphone, and press record and play at the same time. You can put on the ALC or turn it off. It's up to you. Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Testing. This is a test of the Crowncorder cassette recorder in cassette operation. This is the end of the test. And now we'll simply rewind and hear that play back. Testing, testing, testing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Testing. This is a test of the Crowncorder cassette recorder in cassette operation. This is the end of the test. Well, the secondary recorder can record from the cassette itself while it's playing, or it can record through the microphone while you're making a recording, or it can record from the microphone without using the main cassette for recording. First, we'll make a tape on the endless loop without a cassette. So we'll take the cassette out, and all we have to do is push record and play, but we push down the red button. And we go testing, testing, testing the endless loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. End of test. Then you push the stop button on that. Push the stop button here. And to hear it play back, you just simply push the red button again. And we go testing, testing, testing the endless loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. End of test. And we go testing, testing, testing the endless loop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. End of test. If you wanted to make an endless loop recording of what is ever on the cassette, let's do that. So we'll rewind to where the music is playing. Because believe it or not, it will do music. And we put it in play. It is now recording from here to this endless loop tape. We release that. Now we release the cassette. Now all we do is press the red button again. So it's a 15-second endless loop tape. Please watch the rest of the video and find out how did Crowncorder make this happen. We can see that the cassette mechanism is basically a Phillips-type mechanism. There's a motor here, which I believe is controlled by a mechanical governor. With the belt, here is the take-up clutch mechanism, and under this plate here is the capstan. The secret is there is actually a second tape recorder in this mechanism. And where is it? It's right here, over the capstan. And here is the second tape recorder. I've removed the mounting screws, and I'm turning it over very carefully. And you can see it is actually an endless loop cartridge recorder. Here is the little pinch roller. Here is the record erase playhead, because it does erase. And here are the guides for it. The back end of the capstan is extended from a regular cassette recorder and has this sleeve on it to control the speed on the cartridge so that it's a 15-second loop. When this turns, when this is pushed up against here and this is turning, this pinch roller touches here and the spinning capstan turns the cartridge. And this will take place whether the machine is playing back a cassette or recording a cassette. And that is how it's able to make the recordings that it does. And I'll just move this back and forth a little bit so you can see how it engages and disengages from the head. There's the pinch roller. There's the brass capstan. All right, so remember that location.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
The cartridge mechanism is controlled by a switch which has a ramp on it that runs through this lever, and here's the cartridge, and here's the spring that keeps it off the capstan except when it's in use. So let's take a look at that actually running.
1, 2, 3.
Notice
four,
that it pushed that forward.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
So you can see because of the angle of the switch, it moves this. And that's how that works.
Thank you for watching the video about me, the Crowncorder model CTR 9650S. I hope you enjoyed the video, and be sure and look for me in the Vintage Tape Recorder Hall of Fame. Thank you for watching the video about me, the Crowncorder model CTR 9650S. I hope you enjoyed the video, and be sure and look for me in the Vintage Tape Recorder Hall of Fame.